that song.
I'm in love with that song.
I love that song.
I'm in love with that song.
I love that song.
I love that song.
I'm in love with that song.
I love that song.
I'm in love with that song.
Welcome back to the I'm in Love with That Song podcast. Thanks for joining me here on the Pantheon Podcast Network. I'm your host, Brad Page, and each episode of this show, I pick one of my favorite songs, and we explore it together, discovering what makes it a great song. This episode happens to come out just in time for Valentine's Day. And as I mentioned on this show before, I am not a fan of these holidays that are really just an excuse to sell greeting cards and merchandise. But it's also an excuse for me to play a song. So I thought this time we'd listen to, I don't know, maybe this is an anti-Valentine's Day song. This one's by Etta James. It's a song called Love's Been Rough on Me. Etta James is a legend. She was born Jamesetta Hawkins in Los Angeles on January 25, 1938. She was 16 years old when Johnny Otis heard her singing in San Francisco. He asked her if she was 18. She lied. He brought her back to L.A., renamed her Etta James, and she cut her first record with him, The Wallflower, in 1955.
Hey, baby, what do I have to do to make you love me too?
You got to roll with me, Henry.
All right, baby.
Roll with me, Henry.
Don't mean maybe.
Roll with me, Henry.
Any old time.
Roll with me, Henry.
Won't change my mind.
Roll with me, Henry.
All right.
She released a few more singles, but the hits dried up for a while, and so did the good-paying gigs. To find a new opportunity, she borrowed a few bucks from Jackie Wilson and bought a bus ticket to Chicago to meet with Chess Records. Leonard Chess liked her a lot and signed her up. One of her earliest singles for Chess was All I Could Do Is Cry in 1960, written by Billy Davis and Berry Gordy Jr. in the days before he started Motown. She recorded this vocal in one take. Chess Records was home to Muddy Waters, Howlin' Wolf, and Chuck Berry. There wasn't much call for strings, but once they started working with Etta, they pictured her as a balladeer as well as a house rocker, and issued quite a few lushly orchestrated ballads, culminating in the universal classic, At Last.
At last.
If Etta James had never cut another song, her legacy would be cemented by that track alone. But of course, she cut a lot more records than that. In 1963, she released one of my favorite records of hers, a live album recorded in Nashville called Etta James Rocks the House.
You got me running. Got me high.
Yeah. hard to believe that's the same woman who sang At Last. Life was not easy for Etta. She was a heroin addict in the 60s and would struggle with addiction for the rest of her life. Over the course of her career, she would be arrested more than once, in and out of rehab. She spent 17 months in a psychiatric hospital. Somehow, in the midst of all that, she managed to record some great music, like the classic Tell Mama in 1967, recorded in Muscle Shoals, Alabama.
You thought you hadn't found a good girl, one to love you and give you the world. Now you find that you've been misused. Talk to me, I'll do what you choose. I want you to tell mama all about it. Tell mama what you need. Tell mama what you want.
And the B-side of that single was a song just as iconic, I'd Rather Go Blind.
Something deep down in my soul said cry, girl.
Though she was no longer hitting the charts by the mid-70s, and therefore off the general public's radar, she continued to make records for three more decades. In 1997, she released an album called Love's Been Rough on Me, and this is the title song from that album. The song was written by Gretchen Peters, who's released a bunch of her own records, but I think this recording by Etta James was the first time the song had been released. I don't know if Gretchen wrote it specifically for Etta, but she might as well have. Etta delivers it like it was made for her. This is a song about the real cost of love. Love can give you something amazing, but it can also exact a terrible price. I love this song because it doesn't sugarcoat the subject. It's not overly poetic. It's not trying to be clever with its lyrics. It's just laying it all out there, honestly. There are two guitars, very cleanly recorded, one panned more to the left, the other panned hard right, and they're playing off of each other. There's a piano and a little bit of what sounds like a pedal steel guitar. It's all very nicely setting the stage for Etta's vocal.
They say time heals a broken heart. Days go by and the healing starts. They say life goes on. Well, I can't prove it, but I know they're wrong.
I love that line. They say life goes on. I can't prove it, but I know they're wrong. That brings us to the first chorus.
They say life goes on. But I know they're wrong. I can't sleep. I can't eat. I don't seem to be able to get back on my feet. I can't run. I can't hide. And it's tearing me up inside.
I can't eat. I can't sleep. I don't seem to be able to get back on my feet. And with a pretty subtle delivery, Etta makes you believe it.
I can't sleep.
I can't eat. I don't seem to be able to get back on my feet.
That's just a nice little guitar fill there.
Oh, have mercy, baby. Love's been rough on me.
I will admit that I'm not into that distorted guitar part there. I'm all for distorted guitars. Big fan. But I don't think it's needed here. I think that's just a reflection of the time this was recorded in the late 90s. I think if they were making this record today, they would have gone with a different sound. At any rate, here's the next verse. And there's only two verses in this song. Two verses and two choruses, and that's it. 3 minutes. No fat. But honestly, I could have listened to Etta sing this all day.
I had love, but it turned out wrong. I had faith, and when that was gone, well, at least I had hope. But you left me hanging at the end of my rope.
Let's bring up her vocal and listen to that verse again.
I had love, but it turned out wrong. I had faith, and when that was gone, well, at least I had hope. But you left me hanging at the end of my rope.
Love's been rough on me, Etta James. Life was rough on Etta James. Along with fighting addiction, she was diagnosed with Alzheimer's in 2008, suffered a MRSA infection in 2010, and in 2011 was diagnosed with leukemia, which would eventually take her life on January 20, 2012, just before her 74th birthday. If anybody understood this song, it was Etta James. So, this song is my Valentine's gift to you. It's easy for people to say cliches like, it's better to have loved and lost than never have loved at all. But this is a song for everyone who's ever loved and lost and never quite recovered. Have mercy, because love's been rough on us all. Thanks, as always, for being part of the I'm in Love with That Song podcast. You can post a review or comments on our Facebook page or on Podchaser or wherever you listen to the show. You can find all of our previous episodes on our website, lovethatsongpodcast.com, as well as on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, Amazon. Basically, anywhere that you can find podcasts, you will find this show. And don't forget to follow the show so that you never miss any of our new episodes. We're part of the Pantheon family of podcasts, where you'll find a ton of music-related shows, so be sure to check them all out. We'll be back in 2 weeks with a new edition of the I'm in Love with That Song podcast. Thanks for listening to this show on Etta James and Love's Been Rough on Me.
Oh, mercy, baby. Love's been rough on me. Have mercy, mercy, baby. Love's been rough on me.